In this video, you'll learn about the major organ systems of the human body.
Now we'll go through each of the 11 organ systems, starting off with the integumentary system, which consists of the skin, hair, nails, sensory receptors for touch. We also have sweat glands and other exocrine glands like sebaceous glands that are found in the skin. The functions of the integumentary system are to enclose and protect the body, and contains sensory receptors that perform the functions of detecting sensory information for touch. The next system we see here is the skeletal system that consists of bones, cartilage, and ligaments. And the functions of the skeletal system include supporting the body and enabling movement. The muscular system consists of muscles and tendons that function to the muscles contract, pulling on tendons in order to produce motion. And the metabolism of muscles is also important for producing heat and warming our body. The nervous system consists of the brain, the spinal cord, and nerves that connect to the brain and spinal cord. We'll see there's cranial nerves and spinal nerves that connect to the brain and spinal cord. The functions of the nervous system include collecting sensory information, processing this information, and then sending information out in order to regulate organs like the muscles and glands of our body. The endocrine system includes many different endocrine glands, for example, the pituitary gland, thyroid gland, pancreas, adrenal gland, gonads in men, the testes, and in women, the ovaries. And the functions of the endocrine system are to regulate other organs, but through chemical communication, the endocrine system glands produce hormones that are chemical signals that travel through the blood throughout the body in order to regulate other organs. The cardiovascular system includes the organs of the heart and blood vessels. And the functions are to circulate blood around the body in order to deliver nutrients to organs and cells and carry the waste products away from those organs and cells. The lymphatic and immune system includes the organs of lymphatic vessels, lymph nodes, spleen, and thymus. The functions of the lymphatic and immune system are to drain fluid from peripheral tissues, and this fluid is drained into veins to return back to the blood, and also to defend the body against pathogenic organisms like pathogenic bacteria or pathogenic viruses that can make us sick and endanger the body. The respiratory system includes the lungs, bronchi, trachea, larynx, pharynx, nasal cavities, and sinuses. And the functions are to bring air in and out of the body, enabling external respiration where oxygen is transferred into the blood and carbon dioxide is removed from the blood. The digestive system organs include the oral cavity, salivary glands, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, liver, gallbladder, pancreas, and large intestine. The primary function is to ingest food, break that food down, and absorb nutrients from the food, and then eliminate waste from the body. The urinary system organs include the kidneys, ureter, urinary bladder, and urethra. And the functions of the urinary system are to filter blood producing urine. And as the blood's being filtered, the kidneys regulate the composition of the blood, and then any waste or excess water, excess nutrients are eliminated from the body in the urine. The reproductive system In men, includes the testes, epididymis, ductus deferens, seminal glands, prostate gland, and penis. In women, it includes the ovaries, uterus, vagina, vulva, and mammary glands. And the functions of the reproductive system are to produce offspring. The men produce the sperm, the gametes that fertilize the ovum, the female gamete, in order to produce a zygote, that is a cell that will divide and grow inside of the female reproductive tract, inside of the uterus. The embryo will grow into a fetus that will eventually be delivered as the child, as the baby.